Hey crew, happy new year and welcome back on board. For this throwback Thursday video, I took some footage recorded on the Stroombank in November 2021 as we approach the port of Gävle in Sweden. Sadly, the radio communication recordings were lost, so I will narrate the video now and explain a little bit about the procedures that we used during the approach and the maneuvering. So, we are approaching the port of Gävle in Sweden. Before we started the approach, we've done an arrival briefing for the crew. The engineer has changed over from shaft generator to the auxiliary generator and enabled the bow thruster. Deck has prepared for arrival, so both anchors are standby for immediate use. And we have set up all bridge and navigation equipment correctly. In Gävle, pilotage is compulsory for vessels longer than 90 meters overall, but since the Stroombank is 5 centimeters less, we are able to proceed without any pilot. There is no vessel traffic service monitoring the vessel movements in the area, so we will have to make a general announcement on VHF channel 16 stating: all ships in the area of Gävle, this is motor vessel Stroombank, inbound to the port of Gävle, now passing the Eggegrund reporting point. This is motor vessel Stroombank out. All ships are required to make such announcement and monitor the movements of all other vessels to avoid any conflicts. For this approach, I invited the apprentice on the bridge to take the vessel on hand steering. This can be a nice learning experience for him, where he can get a feel for the vessel in his hands. And in the open water, I could still give him a heading that he had to maintain, but as he is still inexperienced for the tight turns and when we were passing a narrow passage, I have to give rudder orders to control the vessel. All in all, a good learning experience for him and a nice opportunity for me to test his progress and if he is ready to take on new responsibilities. All ships in the area of Gävle, this is motor vessel Stroombank inbound to the port of Gävle. Now passing reporting point Puritsgrund. This is motor vessel Stroombank out. Now for the second leg of the approach, I invited the second officer to the bridge. And because he has more experience, we have discussed that he can control both the rudder and the engine commands. And as I give him commands on where I want the ship to be, he has to operate the rudder and engine by himself to bring the vessel there at the speed that I requested. So for him, it's also an opportunity to feel how the vessel responds to his inputs, but on a higher level than what the apprentice was doing. Our berth is at the very end of the last dock, so exactly like in Uddevalla, there is no room for a failed approach, meaning we have to keep a close eye and monitor our speed. I've told the second mate that we need about 6 knots when we enter the channel, and after we turn to the basin, our speed should have reduced to about 3 knots. Now, to do this, we both use the rudder to initiate the turn, and then we pitch the engine astern, so we use the wheel effect as well to continue the rate of turn and reduce the speed at the same time. After the second mate has stabilized the vessel and lined it up for the berth, I can take the controls to the bridge wing and the second mate can proceed to the aft deck for the arrival, and the speed is now down to about 2 knots, so that's a safe arrival speed. Now I bring in the bow close enough for the crew to send the heaving line and the forward spring ashore, and then I pitch astern to bring the stern alongside using the wheel effect, and this also reduces the speed. I will take care of a soft landing and together with the crew and the linesman, we will make the final position.
Five meters to position.
Five to go.
Yeah, then you can make fast and spring.
Forward spring fast.
Forward spring is fast, thank you.
Trombone shaft lines all fast.
When all lines are fast, we can thank the engineer, so he can shut down the engine, and I can shut down all the navigation and bridge equipment for the port stay. So let me know in the comments, what did you think about the explanation in this video? Is there a type of content you want to see more of? And if you have any questions, you can also drop them down below. Thanks again for watching. Please give a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.